Welcome to ProplanX. Today's topic, simplifying process inputs and outputs for the PMP exam. Project Management Institute publishes the 5th edition of the Guide to the Project Management Body of Knowledge, also called as the PMBOK Guide. Before we head on, let me invite you to visit proplanx.com. Click on the blog section so you can access this article called Simplifying Process Inputs and Output for the PMP exam. Here are some interesting statistics. Let's go over that. Within the PMBOK guide, there are 5 process groups, 10 knowledge areas, 47 processes. And across these 47 processes, we have 256 inputs, 153 outputs. Yeah, I agree. That's a huge number of 409 entries in all. If you're like me, you would be wondering, okay, how am I going to remember such a humongous amount of information for the PMP exam? Well, guess what? We at ProplanX have taken the complexity out of all this information here that you're seeing. Well, guess what? We at ProplanX have worked to simplify your understanding of all these inputs and outputs across these 47 processes. That is available as a free download. All you have to do is obtain this free download. Visit proplanx.com, click on the free section, and click on PMP resources. And from here, you can download the free matrix. Now let me take you to the matrix itself. Once you download the matrix, this is what it looks like. Well, I understand. You may be thinking, wow, it looks colorful, but it's so noisy. Believe me, we have taken the complexity out of what exists in the PMBOK guide. I hope you will be able to better appreciate the ease at which you can understand the processes, the inputs and the outputs. Let's start. The first row talks about the process groups, and we have got 5 process groups: initiating, planning, executing, monitoring and controlling, and closing. The second row talks about the 10 knowledge areas. Here we see the process names. All of these blue color represents the planning processes, green color represents the executing processes, the red color represents the monitoring and controlling processes. These colors are just to differentiate between the different process groups. They have got no other significance. Now, on the first column here, what you see is the set of inputs and outputs. Now, with this basic understanding, let's get started. First part, you want to understand how each of this item becomes an output or an input to what all processes. So that's the first stage. Let's understand this. For that, you need to go across the rows. Let's start with one example, project schedule. Go across the row, you will notice an O, and in that particular column, you will notice develop schedule. So project schedule is an output of develop schedule, and you go across, I says input, and it's an input to estimate cost, determine budget, plan procurement management, and control schedule. For a total of 5 processes, so 5 processes are affected by this project schedule. So that is what this number 5 here represents. Second part to understanding this matrix, I want to understand what are the inputs and outputs for a process. For that, you need to go column wise. Let's take the example of sequence activities. If you notice I against OPA, OPA stands for organizational process assets, and EEF is enterprise environmental factors. So sequence activities, the input is organizational process assets, enterprise environmental factors, activity attributes, activity list, and so on and so forth. And what is the output of sequence activities? We notice project schedule network diagrams and project documents updates. Well, we may have more, so we'll just scroll down to see what else we have. So we see the estimate sequence activities, and we notice milestone list. That's yet another output. The interesting thing is we have a little more of information to help you understand how many outputs and inputs a process contains. So sequence activities consists of 7 inputs and 2 outputs. So those are the numbers 2 and 7 here. Now let's go back again. There is another class of encoding that we have done here, which says I and O. You might have noticed I and O here. What this I and O represents is, it's an input as well as an output. The output will be always the update of the input. For example, direct and manage project work. One of the inputs is project management plan, and the output is an update to the project management plan itself. So these are three different ways you can understand this particular matrix, and that simplifies and encompasses all the 409 pieces of information as provided in the PMBOK guide. So with that, let me welcome you back to visit ProPlanX.com and download this free matrix. For that, just go to the free section here, click on the PMP resources and download the PDF poster. Until then, thanks for stopping by.